video ba yan?
Pero photo.
Hey, Shane, can you count if the goalkeeper is exactly in the middle? Otherwise, you have to do it all.
Hey, the goalkeeper is exactly in the middle, Mark.
Hey, yep. Guys, you have no cones on it, huh? Yep. If the cones are on it, you have to cut them off. Looks you have good. To do it somewhere else.
Yep.
Hey, no cones on it?
No balls. Okay.
Yeah. Momento, uno de momento.
Don't have all the rubbish on it.
You've coached in many countries, most of them in Africa. What makes this situation here in the Philippines unique for you?
I told already in the press conference that I was following Philippine football for almost 10 years or more than 10 years. I saw the development. I saw 2019 actually was something unique, and I think 2018 semi-final last time of the, I think at that time still Suzuki Cup or maybe already Mitsubishi Cup. But I saw the potential growing in the league, but also a lot of players with double nationality. So there's more and more choice of players. And when I spoke for the first time with this current federation, that I think it was in December something, then I was immediately impressed about their ambition. And I'm a coach. I had still a contract till August 2026. But I was looking for a new task, an ambitious task, to write history somewhere. And I really believe that with this federation, with their ideas, with their intentions, plus what quality there is in the local league, in Asian leagues, in the United States and in Europe, together with my staff, that we can build something and achieve our goal to go to the Asian Cup in 2027. And on the long term, going to the World Cup. Naturally, we would like to stay as much as possible in the running for the World Cup 2026. Mm-hmm. It's sad that we had already played two home games against Indonesia and Vietnam, where we got only 1 point, but everything is still possible. We are only out when we are 100% out. Mm-hmm. And for me, this task, I was really looking for a task what is pushing me to new limits in a new environment. And I'm very happy now after 1 week being here and what I all see.
Had the chance to check out the local these players here for like a few days now. So what are your thoughts about this coming particular?
I'm very happy when I started. Naturally I heard that okay, the foreign based had always priority, and I understand that when you're professional in Europe or in Southeast Asia in a bigger league, also I would not lie, the majority of my players will be professionals in the bigger leagues. But on the other side, you have to prepare these boys for the moment the chance will be there. And I can guarantee you that from this group, 4 to 5 people will be in Iraq with us, traveling with us. And some maybe will get some game time because we have to prepare them for the future. There's talent, there are quality players. I was a little bit worried when people said we're going to invite university players, but I have to be honest, university players have similar level as the Premier League players and the guys who played in the past abroad. So there's so much quality. I saw the last days, I think 4 or 5 university matches, and I saw Taguig, Manila Diggers and Kaya playing friendly games. So I tried to get used to the league, and I'm positive impressed with the quality of players we have here. And we want to repeat this more, these camps, so that the players get confidence, so that they get to know me. And when we go to Mitsubishi Cup, where probably the majority of the players will be from here or in the region, are much better prepared. I don't want to throw them in the deep end when I need them. I want to prepare them for the moment they are there. And I'm very happy about their cooperation, their motivation, their discipline, but also their skills. It shows that the academies, the coaches, youth coaches, or university coaches and club coaches did a great job. And I'm very happy to work with these guys.
Asian club level, so how does that benefit the motivation?
Yeah, I think naturally the more experience you have, how easier or how better it is if you played in Japan against a big opponent or in South Korea in a big stadium with 30 or 40,000 people, you are better prepared to play in Iraq for 65,000 people. That's clear. But if you never got a chance to do it, it would be useless to say I don't select you because you don't get a chance. I can tell you that in Iraq there will be one or two players who never were in the national team. They will be part of that selection because I want them to experience that full stadium with 65,000 people, so that when they maybe have to play Thailand or Indonesia in the past, that they are well prepared. So for me, experience is important, but you have to give also boys experience to grow. And we have no Ronaldos or Messis. We have all quality players who can achieve something as a goal. And sometimes it doesn't matter where you play, how much you earn, how much experience you have, but how much you want it. And that's also very important.
Coach, this is your first. Is this the same template or plan that you used when you were forming your first team, so when you started coaching the different federations?
It depends from federation to federation. I mean, in Gambia, I started also with a local-based camp, but on the end, I had 150 players playing in Europe. But almost every player, local-based player, I selected. He had one cap and got sold to Europe. That was the way it was working. So it depends from country to country. You can't compare countries with each other because many countries don't have the same infrastructure. I think we are blessed. With very good pitches, with a lot of quality pitches, and we have a lot of talent. And I worked in countries where the youth development was not always that good. We also, the size of the country, if you look to Gambia, we had 2 million people in Gambia. Here we have about 56 times more or something like that. So the choice is bigger. I use naturally my experience and I use my my know-how, but on the other side I have to learn and adapt every time to a new situation. I work close with my technical team, with Coach Norman, with Freddy Gonzalez, and we discuss every day what we're going to do. We re-evaluate ourselves and we try to improve every day to the current situation of here, and we don't want to copy what we did in the past. Yeah, today we had a little bit different setup, less tactical, because we knew the fans would be coming, and if we had a tactical session, it would be maybe a little bit more boring, and some players would have to sit out, and that's not nice. The last days we worked on two principles. That's first of all, not conceding goals. If you go to Iraq and you know that Indonesia scored 5 goals, then it's quite important that you're well prepared tactically and in a way of playing. So we introduced the basic steps of how not to concede goals, how our formation could be. But on the other side, not conceding goals is one, but you want to win and you need to score a goal to win. So we also worked this week on the transition. What do we do when we have the ball? What are the running lines and what are the passes and the actions to do? And that we implemented the last day step by step. And I was really very impressed how fast guys picked it up. And I can't say the guys who played national team were much better. For me, all the boys, even university boys, impressed me, and really they improve a lot. Tomorrow we have the last training session that will be more tactically, an 11 against 11. For sure, we want to repeat this because there's so much talent. And you saw Theo scored yesterday 2 goals, but after the first goal, I already sent to Mikkel and to Vince, I want that guy tomorrow on training, and that's the way I want to work. I will go this weekend to Belgium. On Saturday I will be at the game of Schalke against Paderborn, because I want to meet Obermeier. The week after I will drive by car to Denmark to meet Rasmussen, to be sure that he's on board. Then I will come to Dubai. Then I will watch in April league matches, any level, everywhere, doesn't matter if it's Premier League, school football or anything, to find talent. And then I will travel all the time up and down to find talent in Europe, convince them, but also work here hard for every player who could be spotted. And I always say some players could be good for one coach, and I like maybe a different player. And every player who has a Philippine passport must be knowing that he can be selected. It doesn't matter which experience he has, which age. We prefer naturally young players. We would like to focus on the group from 16 to 26, 27. And there will be sure in the selection against Iraq a few older players. We need players like Neil Etheridge and some other players. But we have to build also on the long term, and that search we want to make and find always new talent for.
You specifically said Lubarnes, you specifically were impressed by him. Past couple games, he was named as the MVP last night and the Golden Boot. Your thoughts about him, having him called up for today's activity?
You mean Theo?
Theo, yes.
Yeah, I saw him only one time yesterday and today also. Naturally, today was my focus not only on him, but he has good speed. And what I like on him is he shoots easy to the goal. And we have sometimes the habit, and it's not only a Philippine habit, it's the modern habit. Players like to touch the ball. They have a chance to shoot, but they want to dribble. They want to touch the ball more, and then the chance is gone. And he has sometimes the fact that he touch it and he shoot, and that we need. And I would like to have some players. Probably now it's too early for him, but I hope this can be a stimulus. Everyone who gets a call up, even if it's a training camp, it's an honor. I mean, from the 150 million people, only 33 people are here. So it must be an honor for every player, and it must be a stimulus to develop. And we will keep on supporting them, helping them to grow. But I have to say that the club coaches, the university coaches, academic coaches do already a brilliant job. I went around, I saw academies on youth level from 4 or 5 years old, and I'm very impressed with everyone in football. Everyone does a great job here.
Coach, just a rejoinder to my first question. What are the unique challenges that are you, how do you plan to address them?
Yeah, the biggest is naturally our travel times, and that we, if you look to Iraq, the majority will play in Iraq and some in Europe, but the distance Iraq-Europe is not that big. If you look to Vietnam and Indonesia, the majority of the players play in the local league. If you look to us, we have players everywhere in the world. So bringing them together in a short period of time, if we have on Thursday a game in Iraq, players can Some can fly Sunday, some can fly on Monday only, so some will arrive only on Tuesday. So a very limited time. That will be a challenge, but that's the reason we have a top medical team, a lot of scientists who will prepare the players so that we don't overload players. We don't want that players get injured. We want to deliver them healthy back to their clubs everywhere in the world. And it will be important that we keep it very simple tactical-wise. The club coach had weeks to prepare his team, and I will have one or two training sessions to get them ready. So we have to work in a very basic note, but I'm used to that. It's my 11th national team job. Only the time difference is a little bit different now in traveling and so on. But I'm surrounded by a brilliant medical team and technical team, and I'm sure we will be ready for every task.
How do you think it's going to be against Iraq, given their super high ranking?
Yeah.
What kind of football do you need to play?
I think that that will be for sure the most difficult match. Iraq is a powerhouse in Asian football. I think personally that Iraq will go to the World Cup in Mexico, Canada. They were in 1986 there for the last time. They were played against Belgium that time. And Belgium had difficulties. Iraq always had a big team. 2007, they became Asian champion. 2 years ago, of a year ago, they won the Gulf Cup, which is a fantastic performance for them. Iraq is a football nation. Everyone loves football. They have the advantage compared to the other Gulf and Arab team countries that they are physically more the European style. They have bigger bodies. They have muscled guys. They play always for a full house, also in the local league, beautiful infrastructure, accommodation. This is a football country, a giant in Asian football. But I love to play against giants. When we played with Gambia in Morocco, we won 0-1. When we played against Algeria, we played 1-1. We beat Tunisia. So a game is not lost before you played it. And we will need motivated guys who are ready to play disciplined, who will face a difficult task, but try to... I think if we could play a draw in Iraq, would be fantastic. And after that, we will see what we can do here. I would be happy if... I would prefer to win both, but then I'm dreaming too much and then I wake up. But I would prefer that we... if we could two draws against them, everything is in our own hands to beat Vietnam and Indonesia in the last games, to even qualify in this stage. If we could win one, for example, the home match, yeah, that would be amazing. But let's not dream too much. Let's work. We have no preparation in friendlies. So let's go for a good 0-0, and I will be very happy with that.
Excited you are for, well, you have a new coach, you're gonna have a new system, and right now you're focused on preparing for the World Cup qualifiers in Iraq. What is your immediate goal for now?
Yeah, so the last 3 months I've been really hard at work, you know, with the substance of the team, preparing the coaching staff, preparing all the backroom staff, communicating with players, trying to put together the best possible team we can. Mm-hmm. To compete against Iraq in the upcoming 2 games in March. So yeah. Right now we're just in the thick of all the preparation, and so we're doing this local based player camp.
Which is this,
yeah. Okay. So we can, Coach Tom wanted to do it because he wanted to see all the local based players. And so before this we did an extensive scouting search for all the really the best players that we felt could be part of the national team and future national squads as well. Yeah.
So for the team that's going to compete against Iraq, are you going to have some from this pool, or is it going to be mostly the veterans, foreign-based ones?
No, we're definitely going to have some from this pool. Mm-hmm. Of course, the camp ends tomorrow. So after the camp, we're probably going to sit down and discuss, you know, who will fit in, what positions. We have a lot of scouting data because we have everybody's wearing like a heart rate monitor, GPS.
Here?
Yeah, we have a camera that's positioned right up there that's basically watching everything we're doing. So we're putting in a lot of science as well into it. It's not just like based on an eye test, you know. So a lot actually goes into modern football now, which is, you know, very different from my time. But so there's a lot of analytics and science involved in also picking the players.
So we have a lot of talent overseas, you know.
Correct.
The Filipinos have grown up or learned their football abroad. So how do you determine the composition of the team? Is it like who's available, or is it going to be the coach, I guess, to fill in the right positions?
So essentially, the coach will decide the lineup in the end. So he will select the players based on how he wants to play. And against each team will be different. So he will visit all the players abroad to watch them in their clubs. And I mean, as you could see here, he's watched how many UAP games?
Yeah.
He's watched the high school finals of the UAP as well. So he's very interested in really seeing the players, not just like in training camps and everything, in their own club environment. But the selection will really be based on who he thinks fits into the style he wants to play, and whether that's from overseas based or local based, it to him it doesn't matter.
So what is his style of football that you want that the team will more or less have?
Well, it's definitely not going to be possession for possession's sake. There's going to be a lot of possession to penetrate moments. So it's all about going forward for him. So even if we're playing a strong team like Iraq, or, you know, when we're playing a team like Japan or Korea or one of those, of course, tactics will shift a little bit. Yeah. But the goal is always, once we get the ball, we play football and we go forward. We're not going to be doing things like, you know, just playing back and side to side. Yeah. It's really like with purpose. So,
yeah. So are you going to have guys like Neil?
Yeah, so Neil will be back.
Who are some of the players that we know will
Neil will be back. Garrett Holtman said he would want to play as well. Michael Baldissimo is going to play his first, he's going to have his first international cap in Iraq. So we have those guys who've never played here. Garrett's played against Mongolia, but he's never played here locally. So that's really exciting. We're still talking, Santi Rublico's coming back. Of course, you know, the ever-reliable Ott brothers are coming back, Patrick Reichelt. So you'll have a mix of, you know, veterans and young players as well. Yeah. So
Freddie, as the manager of the national men's national football team, if there was one thing that, what would be your dream for the team?
Well, definitely the goals are, one is to win the Mitsubishi Cup. So for me, that's... That's one of the ultimate short-term goals, is to win the Mitsubishi Cup. It's about time we won that tournament. We've been to the semifinals twice, and we need to take that next step. The next step is to go as far in World Cup qualifying as we can and to qualify for the Asian Cup in 2027. We got a taste of that in 2019, but I feel like the team wasn't really fully supported for that tournament. So that's another thing that we're really preparing for, is the Asian Cup. Like, we don't want to go to the Asian Cup just to make up the numbers. We want to go to Asian Cup to actually compete and get as far as we can.
Yes. Now, for Filipinos, whether they're here in the country or overseas, who, you know, want to become a part of the national team, what would you say to them? What should they do?
I would say that if you see Coach Saintfiet in any of your games, make sure you show out, because, you know, Coach really loves to watch all levels of football. And so there are a number of UAAP players here, not just PFL players. A lot of UAAP players, even a UAAP juniors player was just invited today after his performance in the finals yesterday. So he's even looking at high school players. So that should give all the players in the country notice that you will be considered no matter what level you play, and as long as you're good enough and you can contribute something to the national team.
And he's here for 4 years at least, Coach Saintfiet.
Yeah, at least. So, you know, I'm hoping he stays longer, but, you know, we're trying to build something, and the only way we can do that is consistency and stability, and the coaching staff is part of that.
Well done.